look at that. I mean, it's turning in front of us. And it's literally, I mean, there's hardly any mistakes. You can see that even when the arms disappear, and it's just leaving the frame. I mean, what the? How does it even know that this is the same thing? I mean, seriously, this is amazing. It just left the frame, came back in.
CineD, your digital cinema tech resource, supported by B&H and CVP.
Hey guys, Nino here from CineD. Apple just dropped Final Cut Pro 11. Yes, you heard that right. It's a major update to Final Cut Pro, which is funny because the last version was called 10.8, so they kind of skipped 10.9, which is very reminiscent of actually Apple skipping the iPhone 9, which never existed. But let's take a look at Final Cut 11. Well, one thing first, there are some major updates in here and they still don't charge money for it. And this is really, really cool. If you've purchased the original Final Cut Pro 10, which at some point they dropped the X, which is like a Roman 10. If you purchased that when they released it like 12 years ago, they still haven't charged a single time for an update since then. Which is great. I mean, it literally is the same model that Blackmagic Design uses for the studio version of Blackmagic Design DaVinci Resolve, which also costs $300, and they've never charged again for it since they took over DaVinci. So Apple is kind of copying that. Of course, there is no free version like with DaVinci, but there's a 30-day trial. So you can head over to apple.com and download the free trial of Final Cut Pro 11 if you haven't used it before. But let's dive right in. Well, there's three major new features that I want to point out today, and I think they're really, really amazing. The major one is called Magnetic Mask. And the Magnetic Mask, you can imagine, is similar to, you know, the automatic subject selection that Photoshop has, which is kind of like AI-based, so it's trained on a lot of photos, and it can actually recognize shapes, subjects, and objects. In a similar way, Final Cut Pro 11 can do that for video, for objects and subjects in a video. And you wouldn't believe how well it works. Let's dive right in. Well, here we have a little clip that is B-roll that I shot for my review of the DJI Air 3S, which we released a couple weeks ago. And yeah, it's a little bit underexposed and, you know, it's just the drone flying. And I picked this clip because I thought, well, what is the most difficult thing we can find for the magnetic mask to track? And that is probably one of those most difficult things, because you have a drone here that's like literally turning with rotors on top, and it's changing its perspective. The lighting changes as it is flying up and down. And what I wanted to try is just simply track that. So in order to add a magnetic mask, you go to Modify, Add Magnetic Mask, and then you get a bunch of controls up there. Most of them are grayed out, but by default, the plus is selected, and that's selected because it allows you to simply select the subject you want to track. And you just click on it and bam, you see it's already really, really good. I mean, you know, like you can see how this is actually a good mask. You can click also on View Masks and then you will see some transparency there. So it's catching some of the rotors, which is almost impossible because, I mean, they're turning and it's not so easy to distinguish what's actually you know, part of the subject and what isn't if something is turning that quickly. So, you know, this is intentionally impossible to do. So that's why I selected it. And then I click on Analyze. And what it does, it's not real time. And I mean, but it's really, really fast. This is 4K footage. And this is an M2 Max MacBook Pro. Like 2 years ago, I bought this. A pretty good machine, but not the latest. I mean, an M4 and M4 Max might be better than that. But look at that. I mean, it's turning in front of us. And it's literally, I mean, there's hardly any mistakes. You can see that even when the arms disappear, and it's just leaving the frame. I mean, what the? How does it even know that this is the same thing? I mean, seriously, this is amazing. It just left the frame, came back in, and it knew that this is the thing that it needs to track. I mean, look how good it is. This is putting rotoscoping people out of work. And now we have this really high contrast sky up there, still doing a great job at tracking. I mean, we are at 25% of the clip. I think this is around 3 minute clip. It's been tracking, you know, probably for like, what, a minute? And the separation to the background. I mean, you see the colors of the leaf and the leaves in the background. It's not an even background. I mean, this is a typical kind of things where the normal want you have, like in Photoshop and stuff, like would be really confused. You know what I mean? It just knows that this is a subject. I mean, Apple says this is AI based, and I'm sure it is. I mean, this must be machine learning. It must have looked at, I don't know, millions of videos, I guess, and just determined what is an object, what is something separate from something else. I mean, there's one bug that we see here is that it's still tracking, but you can see that the footage is not playing back smoothly anymore. I guess this is a small bug because we can still see the bar moving. We still can see the bar moving. We just see this. It's the playback is a little bit choppy. I'm just amazed how well this works. I mean, this is incredible. Look, now it's starting from the beginning. It's just going back from the point in time that I selected. And it's just doing it in both directions, of course. So the entire clip will be tracked. And I think it's always a good idea to start at a point in your clip where the subject is really well visible, because then it will have an easier time to determine when it even, you know, like gets out of focus and stuff like that. Even out of focus works really well. But I mean, you saw what I did. I mean, this was literally two clicks. It's incredible. Okay, it's leaving the frame now. And it's, you know, it's nothing wrong is selected. Well, it's coming back in. Okay, now we have it, so we can kind of go through it like that. Wow. I mean, I'm just amazed. What can I do with it now? So that's the question, right? I mean, the mask is there, and you know how effects work in Final Cut. They're stacked. So if I put an effect below the mask now, only the mask will be affected. And now let's try to remove the background. Just take a look how clean this is. I mean, let's play it back for a second and do full screen here. I mean, you see the rotors are not working, obviously. I mean, they cannot work. This was an impossible thing that I gave it, you know, like to do. But still, this would take a person hours and hours and hours, if not days, to do with a subject like that. I mean, you saw the original footage. Look at it now. Okay, now we have this. That was the only time that something wrong was selected. I mean, it was literally leaving the frame super fast. And now it's coming back. But the thing is, you can fix the mask. So there are ways to fix the mask, even if you have stuff going on like this. So actually, yeah, we see this here. I can go back into the mask. And yeah, now you see that it's selected some of this stuff. So I can click on the minus and bam, it's, you know, I would not think this is possible. Now I can put that drone in front of different background and it would look pretty real, right? Yeah, actually, let's put the drone in, it's like a different background. Yeah, that looks really bad because the movements don't match. But still, I mean, it looks like it's flying there, right? By the way, this, you know, you see log footage here in the background. This was shot with that drone, actually, the Air 3S. And I can go with the new feature called Enhanced Lighted Color, which is an automated way of optimizing color. And it's also AI-based. So it's not just doing a simple thing and just, you know, apply a LUT or something like that. It actually analyzes the footage. So clicking on that, it's enhancing it. I mean, results are, of course, not always perfect, but you can, you know, change everything by yourself. So when you go into this enhanced light and color thing, you can change everything. And of course, we want to have actually more contrast, right? I mean, this is, and there's a lot of backlight here. Not the best shot, I have to say, but I would, you know, rather do apply a standard LUT here to have a starting point, I guess. But this is what enhanced light and color can do, right? You can do automated corrections, which give you a good starting point. Good. But I can show you this on a different clip where it actually works better. Let's try this one. Enhanced light and color. Yeah, much better job here. If you look before and after, I mean, it really had a greenish tint before, which is gone now. and it looks more natural. But still, it's your preference what you want to do with it. So it's just a starting point to modify it from here. Let me show you something else. So if I already know I don't need the mask for several effects, I can simply apply, let's say, the bad TV effect. Yeah, that's, you know, typical old VHS video. And then I have the option here of adding a mask, and we know the other options of adding color masks and shape masks, but now there's a magnetic mask as well. And same thing, I just press on the subject and you see it just almost perfectly recognized me here, even the hair up there. I mean, if you zoom in, let's just magnify this. It's incredible. It's incredible. Just, yeah, view the mask. Look at this. It's doing a really good job. It's not, you can't do this much better if you do it manually. Actually, I think it's much worse. Okay, and then let's just click analyze, and it's doing its thing again. Much shorter clip, so it shouldn't take as long. Same thing here, you know, like, I mean, he's kind of making a bit of a weird tilt, which leaves part of my head out of the shot. No problem. For the magnetic mask, it's not going crazy, because that's the typical thing, right? Even it's like autofocus on cameras. If a subject leaves the frame and comes back in, that's when it's really challenging an autofocus. And I guess it's the same for something like this, but it doesn't seem to have a problem. So now this is only, okay, the mask is there. I can click done, bam. And you see that the bad TV effect is only applied to me. It almost looks like I was recorded in green screen. I look like a hologram. I look like a hologram from Star Wars or something. It's incredible. I mean, it's never been that easy to do this. I've not seen any way. If there is an easy way to do this in a different application, let me know. I mean, this is a nice shot that I shot a couple weeks ago in a forest here in Austria. And yeah, very nice shot. This is also log. So let's try the enhanced light and color automations here. It's a bit bluish to my taste, so I would definitely, well, it's actually decrease the warmth. Let's increase the warmth here. Highlights tint, yeah, it's a little bit of a tint. We want more colorful fall, right? But what about, I mean, this is actually a shot from a documentary about a famous composer. And this was the Gustav Mahler, and this was the composing hut he was writing some of his symphonies in. So what if we decided to add, you know, like make this hut look aged, you know, like aged film or something like that? Yeah, we have aged film here. I mean, this is a really difficult shot too, because of course we have like these branches. I mean, the drone is flying towards the hut. And we have all these branches here. So, I mean, this is not an easy thing, right? I would start the tracking around here simply because then it can track forward, which is probably the most difficult thing it has to do, because, I mean, we have these fine branches kind of leaving the frame, not quite before it ends. And then let's go back. Yeah, let's just try. I mean, I'll use the aged film effect, just drop it on here. And then I want to do a mask. So magnetic mask, bam. Okay, it's having a much harder time on this one, as you can see, but I can still click plus, and then it's already much better. I don't want it to leave out the window either. So I'm clicking on the window, clicking on the roof. I'm clicking on this part of the roof. I don't want these branches here selected. So let me actually zoom in here. And let's try if we can ignore those. Yeah, much better job. Look at that. Here we go. Okay, well, this is difficult because, I mean, where does the floor start and the house end? But again, doing a pretty good job here. We want to add this. Okay. I think this is a good starting point. What do you think? Good. Let's go back to fit. Oh, here's one more. Okay. And now let's press analyze. And again, it looks like it's doing a good job. And now it's coming towards the end of the clip and it's going backwards to what it still needs to process. good, here we go. And then now we're done. The mask looks pretty good. Not much to complain about. Just click done. Now we have the aged film effect on this. It's not too apparent, actually, because I think it's the type of effect. So we probably want to, well, make it black and white. Why not? And you will see, actually, I mean, that's the crazy thing about Final Cut, right? It's so performant. You can just drag sliders in real time on a laptop and jitter them out. Oh, this is nice. Okay, let's look at this in full screen. I mean, this is pretty cool. You saw how long this took me to do. It's not 100% perfect at the branches, but I mean, it's probably, what, 98% perfect? It's good enough for what most of us need. And I think I would even say this is good enough for TV, even cinema. I mean, this tracking is insane. So Magnetic Mask is, in my opinion, really propelling Final Cut Pro 11 to a completely new position in the market. I haven't tried something like that in DaVinci. There might well be, and if you know, just leave a comment, there might well be a technology like that built into Fusion or whatever. But DaVinci Resolve is much more complex to operate and takes a lot more training. You saw how easy this was. I literally only clicked a few times and I'm done, right? And so fast. So this is amazing. And I can see this changing a lot of things for a lot of creators and filmmakers. Incredible. I will certainly use this for a lot of productions, and I'm sure many others will. It's just really, really, really nice to see that Apple is really making a huge effort and proving that they are still very much behind Final Cut Pro and really taking it to the next level. And I think the Magnetic Mask alone will be something which makes a lot of people consider switching to Final Cut. At least it, I mean, I'm editing with Final Cut anyway, but I think I would probably switch from Premiere if I saw this, because this opens so many possibilities. Just imagine, it's going to be so easy to put a text behind a subject, or, you know, like just color grade parts of an image. You know, like you can just say, well, I want this part of the image to be brighter. I want this more colorful. I want to differentiate things. This is going to be so much easier than it was before. So really excited for that. Congratulations, Apple, for a really, really cool release, and even more so that it's free for any existing users of Final Cut Pro. Anyway, this is a long video. Thanks for watching if you stuck through until the end. And please don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel if you want to see more videos like this one. And see you on the next one. Bye.